the Shidduch crisis and the four kashas, which is Bashert, Halacha, maturity, and how can the crisis be stopped. Basically, we'll briefly review the Shidduch crisis. We need to know two things. First is that Hasidim both start at age 18. The boys and the girls start at age 18. In the yeshiva world, where he starts at 23 and she starts at 19, that's the first thing. The other thing we need to know is that there is population increase. Baruch Hashem, Ken Yirbu. For practical purposes, we will use 5%. Assuming the same amount of boys and the same amount of girls are born. We will use this. 1,000 boys and 1,000 girls born in 1 year, 1,050 the next year, 1,150, 1,200, and so on. By Hasidim, when 1,000 boys and 1,000 girls are born, in 18 years from now, 1,000 meet 1,000. In 19 years from now, 1,050 go to Shidduch Island with 1,050, next year 1,100 with 1,100. Theoretically, in Shidduch Island, the same amount of boys and the same amount of girls are there. However, in the yeshiva world, where he starts at 23 and she starts at 19, so we're talking about a 4-year age gap. The boys will wait till 23. So when 1,000 boys reach 23, how many 19-year-olds are there? 1,000, 1,050, 1,150, 1,200. So we're talking about 1,000 boys getting 1,200 girls. Next year, 1,050 getting 1,250. Next year, 1,100 get 1,300, and so on. Always 20% more girls than boys are being fed into Shidduch Island. So this is a theoretical thing. It was presented to the Gedolei Yisrael and Eretz Yisrael. In theory, but we went even a little further and we got a hold of actual numbers. In 2015, actual numbers in Lakewood, we took the amount of bar mitzvah boys and the amount of 9-year-old girls in the whole school system in the whole Lakewood. And it showed there are 890 bar mitzvah boys. And with population increase 4 years later, we're talking about 1,125 9-year-old girls. Move the clock ahead 10 years, where you have 890 23-year-old boys entering Shidduchim with 1,125 19-year-old girls. So when you have this 4-year age gap, you have 1125 minus 890, 235, means 21% more girls than boys are being put into Shidduch Island. So people asked, maybe it was a coincidence in that year. We got a hold from the Avichai Foundation, where they gave us the actual numbers of 12-year-old, 11-year-old, 10-year-old, 9-year-old boys and girls. And we did the same. We moved them down 4 years, and they showed the exact same percentages, which means when you move these 1,237 6-year-olds, when they will be 19-year-olds, and the 991 boys will be 23 years old, so we're talking, with the 4-year age gap, we have 20% extra will be entering Shidduchim. Next year, again, always 20% extra. The average shows the exact same thing, what we were talking about before, that there's always 20% more girls than boys entering Shidduchim at the same time. This is the actual, where you can see it, the actual problem of the Shidduch crisis. The imbalance of age, the lopsided figures, always putting in more younger than older into Shidduch Island. This was presented, as I mentioned before, the Gedolei Yisrael and Eretz Yisrael. They said that Bachrim are mechuyev to start Shidduchim earlier because of Leisamoid al Dam Re'echa. Now we will get to several questions, which is, like I mentioned before, the four kashas. Now we will talk about Bashert. Many ask, why are we getting involved with numbers when a Shidduch, Chazal say, is Bashert, Bas Ploni L'Ploni? The fact is that in Halacha, Bashert is not mentioned. As a matter of fact, when we find the Gemara and we find that the Shulchan Aruch clearly says differently, on the contrary, then we know that we go according to the halacha. Halacha states very clearly that if a person has a shidduch, he should do it on Tisha B'Av. He should not wait another 12 hours. Shema yekadmenu acher. Now, the question comes up, if a shidduch is beshert, why not wait another 12 hours? So we see in one case that halacha does not consider the whole topic of beshert. There's another halacha, a person should write at noyim on Chalamoid, even though ksiva is osir, you're not allowed to write, but a tnoim should be written. What about Bashert? Why not wait till after Yontif? So again, we see that halacha does not pasken with the Gemara of Bashert. Now we will get to the next topic, which is halacha. What is really the halacha on this? Shulchan Aruch, Evan Ezer, Simon Aleph, Siv Gimel. Clearly states a person is supposed to get married young. However, the Shulchan Aruch goes on and he says, Mihu, im oisik b'toyre v'toret bo, he is strongly immersed in learning, and this same bacher, umisyare lisa isha kadei shelo yatriach b'mzoynoi, he is afraid that he will not have food. And the third condition, says the Beis Shmuel, v'hu im ein yitzroi mizgaber olav. Only a bacher that has all these three conditions is allowed to delay. The first one we said, he has to be strongly immersed in learning. So I have here a sefer, Torah B'Tahara, which was written by Reb Kalman Kron, that's Pesach Kron's brother. He brings over here, brought from Rav Shach, that strongly immersed in learning means that he goes to sleep with a Torah question and he gets up with the answer. Very few can say they are on that madrega. He also has to have the second condition, which is he is afraid that he wouldn't have food. Between the wife supporting, family supporting, and other ways, no one in America has a problem with food. So that's strike two. And the third condition, which is that his yetzer is not misgaber olav. So again, the Sefer Torah B'Tahara from Rav Kron, he brings this from the Chazon Ish, that he said, who can say that on himself, that his yetzer is not misgaber on him? And this was said more than 50 years ago without today's nisyonos. So there really is no halacha heter for a boy to say, I'm not listening till 23. You want to learn? Learn after the chasana. Today, koilel is such a standard that there is no heter to say, like it was years ago, there is no heter today to say, I'm not listening to shaduch until 23. So this is the halacha part of it. We're talking about halacha. I also want to show the Das Torah of the Gedolei Yisrael and Eretz Yisrael, what they wrote, what they signed about. They recognize that the age gap is the problem and what needs to be done. They are writing here that Be'ezus Hashem Yisbarach Nizgala Lanu. By now we know the reason why this is happening. They are recognizing that the problem is the age gap, and they are mechuyev to start younger because of Leisamei Del Dam Re'echa. And they are writing over here, Achayva Mutelis, there's an obligation on yeshivas, Rashi yeshivas, on Bachrim, to do everything possible to start younger. This is signed by the Gedolim in Eretz Yisrael, Rav Aaron Leib Steinman, Zechrono Livracha, Rav Alyoshev, and Rav Orbach, Zechrono Livracha, and Yevod L'Chaim Toivim, Rav Chaim Kanievsky added a few words, saying that is, although years ago they started later, but it is better to start earlier, since today you can learn in Koyl, it's a standard thing. Yungalite can learn Torah B'Tahara, and this is the right way, and this is what has to be done. This is what Reb Chaim Kanievsky Shlita signed on. So the Das Torah on this fully recognizes the age gap, and the psak is that they have to start younger. According to our charts, if the boys would start at age 21, it would be a Olam HaTikun, and there will be no Shidduch crisis. And this is what everybody should do, is encourage Bachrim to start Shidduchim at age 21, Mitzvah Halacha and Das Torah. Now we will address the third topic, which is maturity. Many think that American boys are not mature until 23. But I'd like to ask, the whole world, Eretz Yisrael, Europe, everyone starts Shidduchim at age 20, 21. Chassidim all over the world, followers of the Chazon Ish, they are mature, they start Shidduchim at age 18. Now, is it only the Americans that need till 23? Definitely not. We also see in Eretz Yisrael, an Israeli soldier takes the position at age 18, Habol Laharga Chashkem Lahargai. So this is only because he feels he still has another 2 years to go to Eretz Yisrael, whether to learn, whether to take it easy, or go touring. And so he goes from 21 to 23, he goes to Eretz Yisrael, and then he comes back and starts Shidduchim at 23. Which this is really the cause of the whole Shidduch crisis, the waiting from 21 to 23 and not listening. So getting back to maturity, if everyone is mature before, it's because that's when they start Shidduchim. If an American Bachar knows that he starts at age 21, he will be mature at age 21. And the couple will mature together. They will adjust to each other from a younger age. It's a much better and a nicer Shidduch when they start at age 21. And this is really what has to be done. Keneged arba banim dibra Torah. Echad roitz lilmoid, echad ein roitz lilmoid, echad tam, that's waiting till 23, ve'echad she'ein yodeya lishel ha'alocha, keneged kulam dibra toira, loitoy ve'yoysa odom levadoi, loisamoid al dam re'echo, and there is a ve'loysa suru, achre levavchem achre yanechem, there is kedusha involved. This system must stop. They cannot go to Eretz Yisrael from 21 to 23, cause the crisis, and be over on the lavin that we mentioned before. They must change. This is the Das Torah. The yeshivas all agree that they all should start at age 21. Now the fourth question. Who can stop the Shidduch crisis? The answer is, anyone listening can stop it. Now that we know the cause of it, which is the Bachar not listening till 23, and his parents, the way to stop this, and anyone could stop it, is to tell them they are putting at risk their own daughter, niece, cousin, by waiting till 23. It is something that people have to do themselves. No Rosh Yeshiva, Rav or Rebbe told anybody to join Hatzalah, Tom Chishabas, Bikur Cholim, Saskim, other good things that people do. This was all done through Balbatim, taking the situation serious and caring about another, the Yid, another person that has a Bsyakov girl, a daughter, to marry off. This must be addressed. Everybody has to take this serious and stop this waiting around till 23. This deafening silence must stop. To summarize, the Shidduch crisis is a man-made tragedy. 800 boys waiting till 23 simultaneously get 1,019-year-old girls. Next year, when 1,000 boys wait till 23, they're getting simultaneously 1,250 19-year-olds. This is keeps on feeding the market with 20% more year after year after year after year. The only way to stop this is by stopping Bachram from going from age 21 to age 23 to Eretz Yisrael and not listening to Shidduchim. They must listen to Shidduchim at age 21, and the crisis will, Be'ezus Hashem, be over. The four kashas that were mentioned is Bashert, as we said before. Bashert is not mentioned in Halacha. On the contrary, Halacha is very clear that we don't consider the whole topic of Bashert. Halacha Lamaisa, just go on with the Shidduch. The Halacha is only someone with three conditions, which is someone that is strongly immersed in learning and doesn't have food, and in Yisrael Mizgabarol, there is no American Bachar that has all of these three conditions, so there is no heter al pi halacha to wait till 23, and the story is very clear about it, that boys must start younger. Maturity, the younger they start, the better it is, they start together. When a Bachar knows that he is entering Shidduchim at 21, he will be mature at 21. Who can stop the Shidduch crisis? Everyone can stop it. Tell your brother, brother-in-law, nephew, cousin that they should start Shidduchim at 21, read them Shidduchim at 21, because they are endangering their own daughter, niece, or cousin, or other people that they are putting into danger of Chas V'Shalom getting a sentence of staying Chas V'Shalom single forever. So, everybody has this achrayas, and they have to do this, and the crisis will, Be'ezus Hashem, be over. Copies of the Kol Koyres, all of this can be seen on shidduchcrisis.com, and they can write to us at 21libby@gmail.com, 21libby@gmail.com. We can send you some other information over there. Thank you very much. Please do your share. Thank you.